We've made spinach flour tortillas and tortillas prepared with cream cheese, but today I'm going to show you the traditional way on how to prepare homemade flour tortillas. Start by adding 3 cups of all-purpose flour to a bowl, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 cup of shortening, lard, or a combination of both. Add it to the bowl with the rest of the ingredients and mix it in until it's completely incorporated with the flour. You'll know it's ready when it has a grainy-like texture and it looks similar to this. We're also going to need 3/4 of a cup to 1 cup of very warm water. It's very important that your water is nice and warm because this is what's going to help dissolve the shortening or the lard. Start by adding 1/2 of the water first and continue to add a little bit at a time. The amount of water you use could vary depending on the type of flour that you use or the climate that you live in. I ended up using the entire cup of water for the dough. And as you can see, the dough is a little bit sticky, which is perfectly fine because this is just the way we want it. Once it looks like this, we're going to transfer it to a clean working surface and continue to knead it for an additional 5 to 7 minutes. Although it may seem very sticky and you may be tempted to add a little bit more flour, try not to do so. Continue working it for an additional 5 to 7 minutes or until it comes together and it no longer sticks to your hand or the surface. You may have noticed that I did not add any baking powder to the dough. I prepare tortillas many times and every time I add the baking powder, the tortillas tend to harden up. When I leave out the baking powder, my tortillas come out super soft. Once our dough is nice and smooth and it's no longer sticking to our hands, we're going to separate it into equal sized 1-inch rounds. With the amount of ingredients we used, we made a total of 15 1-inch rounds. This is going to give us a good 8 to 10 inch round tortilla. Place the dough back into the bowl and cover them with a clean kitchen towel or plastic to keep them from drying up. Allow them to rest for 10 to 15 minutes before you begin to roll them out. Sprinkle a generous amount of flour to your working surface and rub a good amount of flour to your rolling pin as well. Using your finger, spread your first piece of dough into about a 3-inch round. Dust it in the flour front and back and begin to roll it out into an 8 to 10 inch round. As you're rolling it out, turn it over frequently so it doesn't stick to the surface. Add more flour if needed. If it doesn't come up perfectly round, once we get it to the size that we need, before we take it over to the preheated comal, we're going to stretch out the sides to get them nice and even. I preheated my comal over medium heat for about 10 minutes. Now we're going to take this over to the comal and very carefully we're going to place it on the comal. Cook for about 8 to 10 seconds on the first side or until you start to see small bubbles like this form. Turn it over and cook for an additional 10 to 15 seconds. Turn it over once again and cook for an additional 5 to 6 seconds or until it puffs up. Don't be too discouraged if your tortillas don't puff up all the way. Most tortillas puff up a few bubbles at a time and not one big bubble, so don't be too discouraged if it doesn't look exactly like that one. Repeat the process with the remainder of the tortillas until you're all done. These tortillas come out super thin, soft, and are just plain delicious and are perfect for quesadillas, burritos, or just about anything that your heart desires. If you do happen to have leftover tortillas, a great way to keep them nice and soft like this is by placing them in a plastic bag or Ziploc bag. They can last in the refrigerator for up to a week. And enjoy!